Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6", weighed 245. Kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. Everybody knew he didn't give no lip. Big John. Big John. Big bad John. Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. Didn't say much, kind of quiet and shy. If he spoke at all, he just said hi. Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got into a fight over Cajun Queen. Crashing low from the huge right hand, sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land. Big John. Big John. Big bad John. Then came one day at the bottom of the mine when a timber cracked. Men started crying. Miners were praying and their hearts beat fast. And everybody thought that they'd breathe their last. Except John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell walked a giant of a man that the miners knew well. Grabbed a sack of timber, gave it with a groan, like a giant oak tree just stood there alone. Big John. Big John. Big bad John. With all his strength, he gave a mighty shove. Then a miner yelled out, "There's a light up above." 20 men scrambled in a would-be grave, and now there's one left down there just to see. Big John. With jacks and timbers, they started back down, and they came that rumble way down in the ground. Smoke and gas fell from out of that mine, and everybody knew it was the end of the line. Big John. Big John. Big bad John. Now they never reopened that worthless bit. They just placed a marble stand in front of it. A few lines are written on a stand. At the bottom of this mine lies a big, big man. Big John.